Now let's we understand the term saturation, adiabatic saturation. If we take a psychometric chart, in this psychometric chart we draw the various process, that is the vertical line above the point O. If the direction is upward, then it will show humidification. If the direction is downward, then it will show dehumidification. If the direction is towards left, then it will show sensible cooling. If the direction towards right, then it will show sensible heating. And if we combine sensible heating and humidification, and sensible heating plus dehumidification and sensible cooling plus dehumidification, etc., then the process, the other processes, sensible cooling plus humidification, sensible cooling plus dehumidification, sensible heating plus dehumidification, sensible heating plus humidification. In desert cooler, the process sensible cooling and humidification occur. The other name of this process is adiabatic saturation. In adiabatic saturation, the point that is in superheated region, this point goes up to saturation curve. Means when we reach at saturation curve or 8.2, then the relative humidity of the air will 100%. Means air will 100% humidified or air will fully saturated. In this condition, what will affect on the various term, that is temperature, specific humidity, dew point temperature, relative humidity, enthalpy, wet bulb temperature, and the specific volume. What will affect on all these term? The other process occur on a psychometric chart, that is sensible cooling plus dehumidification. This process occur on summer air conditioner, and sensible heating plus humidification, this process occur on a winter air conditioner. Now we start or we discuss saturation, adiabatic saturation. Adiabatic term, if the adiabatic term come, it means that the enthalpy during the process will remain constant. For example, if we take example of a process adiabatic humidification. In adiabatic humidification process, the enthalpy during the process will remain constant. The other name of the adiabatic saturation is adiabatic humidification is chemical humidification. So in adiabatic, the term adiabatic means in psychometric chart, the enthalpy during the process will remain constant. During adiabatic saturation, we go from superheated region to a saturation curve. At saturation curve, the relative humidity of the air will 100% or air will 100% humidified. So what will affect on the various term? Dry bulb temperature, the direction of the increasing towards plus x. Specific humidity, the direction of the increasing towards plus y direction. So if we goes from point 1 to point 2 or the process adiabatic saturation takes place, then the dry bulb temperature will decrease. Here you can see on a psychometric chart, this is line diagram for a psychometric chart. Specific humidity will increase because they are horizontal line on a psychometric chart. So specific humidity will increase. Dew point temperature line will also horizontal line, but they are non uniformly spaced on a psychometric chart, but specific humidity line uniformly spaced. Dew point temperature line away from the direction of the dew point temperature line is away from the saturation curve, but the direction of the specific humidity towards the saturation curve. So dew point temperature will also increase. Next one is relative humidity. What will affect on relative humidity? At we reach saturation curve, then air will 100% humidified. Means in superheated region, the air will unsaturated. When we reach at saturation curve, then air will 100% humidified. Means the direction of the increasing of the relative humidity towards the northwest direction. Northwest direction. East, south. So the relative humidity will increase of the air, then this will increase. What will affect on the enthalpy? The effect on the enthalpy is nothing. During the process, enthalpy will remain constant. Bed well temperature. Enthalpy lines and the bed well temperature line have same degree of inclination on saturation curve. Sorry, psychrometric chart. So the effect on the bed well temperature and the enthalpy will remains same. So the bed well temperature will also constant. But what will affect on the specific volume? If we compare the term enthalpy, bed well temperature and the specific volume, then all of them specific volume has highest degree of inclination in psychrometric chart. If we take example, suppose this is 80 kJ per kg enthalpy, this is 90 kJ per kg enthalpy, sorry, this will 85, this will 90, this will 95 kJ per kg. If we draw bed well temperature, suppose this is 20 degrees Celsius, this for 25 degrees Celsius, this for 30 degrees Celsius, because specific enthalpy line are uniformly spaced, but bed well temperature line are not uniformly spaced on a psychrometric chart. But the degree of inclination, enthalpy and the bed well temperature line are equals, so they have equal degree of inclination, but specific volume has highest degree of inclination. So this is only difference between specific volume, bed well temperature line and the enthalpy. If we draw the line for all of three, then specific volume will decrease, because the direction of increasing of all of three is towards the northeast direction. But if the process adiabatic saturation takes place, then the direction is towards the northwest, so the specific volume will decrease. So the specific volume will decrease during the saturation or adiabatic saturation process. So this is some information related to adiabatic saturation. Desert cooler. In desert cooler, the process sensible cooling plus humidification takes place. The other name of this process is adiabatic saturation. And summary air conditioning, sensible cooling plus dehumidification takes place. In winter air conditioning, sensible heating plus humidification takes place. So this is about sensible or adiabatic saturation process. Thank you.